Happy Monday evening, everyone. I wanted to bring the daily devotion to you, and I want to do it a little differently today. I want to give you just a thought at the beginning here, and then just let the Word of God speak for itself by reading several passages of Scripture. There could be no better devotion than to cut down on commentary and make the Word of God the main focus, and that's what I want to do tonight. I was hearing someone speak this weekend. And they brought up the chapter out of Jeremiah 29, 13, and 14, the first part of 14. And it got me to thinking, because it's talking about seeking God with all your heart. And we, I think, making a foolish assumption that we ourselves have sought God with all of our hearts, because we attend church, we read the Bible, we pray, we fast, we don't sin. We don't commit immoral sins. We keep ourselves from certain things. But we're living in a world that is really, really damaging everything about God and about moral living. And the judgments of God are up for grabs. I mean, today, every judgment of God is being challenged, and churches by the dozens are caving into the morality of the modern man. And they're succumbing to this immoral world. And so the judgments of God are no longer being amened from the perspective of Christians, but we're actually finding ourselves winking and amening fellow human beings on the basis of humanitarian love rather than standing up for righteousness and saying amen to the judgments of God. And that is, whatever God has determined is right. And so I want to challenge you in today's daily devotion to ask yourself this very serious question. And don't think about anyone else but you, because chances are, because God knows your heart so well, that a lot of things that are going on in your life are because you really haven't sought God with all your heart. You've sought God to some degree, maybe more than others that you know. But I think we're living in a day where there are so few people actually serving God in a situation where they're really sold out to Him that we kind of are lulled to sleep and thinking that we're doing things wholeheartedly that maybe we're not. We really need to ask ourselves if we are or not. And here's how the passage goes in Jeremiah 29, 13. God speaks and He says, "When you search for me, then you will find me. And if you seek me with all your heart, and I will let myself be found by you," declares Yahweh. I think I said that wrong. Let me say that again. If you seek me with all your heart, and I will let myself be found by you, declares Yahweh. Now, let me take you to Deuteronomy 4, 29. Once again, I'm going to minimize my commentary. I'm just giving you exactly what's coming from the Word of God, and I ask you to prayerfully consider these things. They are challenging, and there's a lot of people that don't believe this today, but it is from the Word of God, and it is applicable to the church in so many ways. So please take it seriously. Deuteronomy 4, 29 through 31. "But from there you will seek Yahweh, your God, and will find him, if you seek him with all your heart and with all your soul. In your distress," he's talking about when he puts them out into exile and they're not in their own country. "In your distress, when all these things have found you in the latter days, then you will return to Yahweh your God, and you will listen to his voice. For Yahweh your God is a compassionate God. He will not abandon you, and he will not destroy you, and he will not forget the covenant of your ancestors that he swore to them." That he swore to them. So ask yourself, are you in trouble? Are you in distress? Maybe Yahweh is reaching to you just like he was reaching to them. Deuteronomy chapter 30, verses 1 and 2. "And then, when all of these things come upon you, the blessing and the curse that I have set before you, and you call them to mind among the nations, where Yahweh your God has scattered you, and you return to Yahweh, and you listen to his voice according to all that I am commanding you today, both you and your children, with all your heart and with all your inner self. And then in 1 Chronicles 28:9, it says, this is David's charge to Solomon, his son. And you, Solomon, my son, know the God of your father and serve him with a whole heart and a willing mind. For Yahweh searches all hearts and understands every plan and all thoughts. If you seek him, he will be found by you. But if you abandon him, he will reject you forever. 2 Chronicles 15, 1 and 2. Now Azariah, the son of Obed, the Spirit of God came upon him, and he went out before Asa, and he said to him, Hear me, O Asa, and all of Judah and Benjamin. Yahweh is with you while you are with him. And if you will seek him, he will be found by you. But if you forsake him, he will forsake you. Ezra 8, 21 through 23. I proclaim the fast there at the river Ahava to humble ourselves before our God in order to seek from him a safe journey for us, our children, and our possessions. For I was ashamed to ask the king for troops and horses to protect us from enemies on the way because we said to the king, the hand of our God is favorable to all who seek him, but his strength and his anger are against all who forsake them. So we fasted and sought our God for this, and he responded to our prayer. And then out of Job chapter 8, verses 5 and 6, But if you pray to God and seek the favor of the Almighty, and if you are pure and live with integrity, he will surely rise up and restore your happy home. And then we find in Psalms 9 and 10, And those who know your name will trust in you, for you do not forsake those who seek you, O Yahweh. And then the psalmist wrote in 69, 32, and 33, The afflicted will see and rejoice. O God seekers, let your heart revive, because Yahweh hears the needy and does not despise his own who are prisoners. Psalms 91, 14 and 15. The great psalm written by Moses, I believe. This is his writing. Because he loves me, therefore I will deliver him, God is saying, of his servant. I will protect him because he knows my name. He will call upon me, and I will answer him, and I will be with him in trouble, and I will rescue and honor him. Isaiah 55, 6 through 9. Seek Yahweh while he lets himself be found. Call him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the man of sin his thoughts. And let him return to Yahweh that he may take pity on him, and to our God, for he will forgive manifold. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, and your ways are not my ways, declares Yahweh. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so my ways are higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Lord Jesus, we pray today that you will help us to examine ourselves, to see whether we be in the faith, and to see whether our hearts are truly set out and intent to know you and to find you and to seek you. Lord God, help us, strengthen us, make us strong, and help us to be men and women of the Word of God, letting the Word of God transform our life and being revived by his promise, as it says in Psalms 119, your word revives me, your promises revive me. God bless all of you. Thank you for watching. We'll talk to you soon.